So all the memory protection stuff that we have talked about, how can we use that to prevent malicious code execution on the stack? Okay, remember, you're going to alter the return address, then you're going to insert some instructions where you're going to transfer control and things like that. So one of the things we're going to do is, what if we have a non-executable stack? We actually talked about that's one of the protections for code injection, because you have to inject your code, then you overwrite the return address to point to this code, and then you execute that code. That's how a successful exploit works. So now think what we can do if we made the stack non-executable. Okay, so this is important. Non-executable stack, which means you could go right into it. You can store some instructions into it. So in some sense, you're able to inject the instructions onto the stack, but you will not be able to execute those, okay? Because remember, we're talking about address translation and page table entries and read, write, execute permissions in each of those pages that you can access through those page table entries. Well, if we say it's not executable, okay? Non-executable is you can only read or write those memory location when you want to fetch an instruction off the stack. This is your injection code that we're talking about. But you can't execute off that. So setting the permission to non-execute actually is going to prevent malicious code to inject code on the stack and use buffer overflows to transfer control to it and successfully exploit a program by doing that. Simple thing we can do is you can't execute off the stack, so your injection code can't be on the stack. So this sort of protection, actually, modern operating systems make the stack non-executable. So the way you understand that is this protection comes because that portion of the address space where the stack lives, the page table entries that are used to translate addresses from this range of addresses with the stack is, those page table entries have execution permission turned off. So you can't execute off the stack because it's going to require that you fetch an instruction from a certain memory location where the execute permission is not there. So memory isolation protection, that discussion we've been having, gives us a simple way to protect execution on the stack by making the stack non-executable. And that avoids or prevents this malicious code to use buffer overflows and use code injection on the stack.